So Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubayr ibn Awam, and those who were with them, has to be understood they were not looking for Khilafah. And they were also not nullifying the Khilafah of Ali ibn Abi Talib or seeing that Ali's Khilafah was illegitimate. La. And they did not once criticize Ali ibn Abi Talib. And they did not ever say, وَلَا طَعَنُوا وَلَا طَعَنُوا عَلَيْهِ وَلَا ذَكَرُوا فِيهِ جَرْحًا. And they never said anything about him. And they rather, وَلَا بَايَعُوا غَيْرَهُ. And they didn't also give pledge of allegiance to anyone other than Ali. And rather, they didn't also even come out to fight with the people of Basra. Not at all. Ahnaf ibn Qais narrated this when Uthman ibn Affan got sieged in his house. Who got sieged? Uthman was sieged in his house. He said, at that time, when Uthman was in his house, I went to Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Ahnaf ibn Qais is saying, I went to Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubayr ibn Awam, and I asked them, that I said to them, Ma ta'muruni, what do you guys order me? As for verily, I see Uthman as a dead man. Uthman is killed. He's going to go. Uthman's gone. What do you guys advise me? And they said to me, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubayr ibn Awam, both said to me, Alayka bi Aliyin, if Uthman is killed, Ali is the one. He said that I went to Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha and I said to her, Ba'da qatl Uthman, when Uthman was killed, after Uthman was killed, Aisha, he asked her in Mecca, he said to her, what do you tell me? What do you say to me? What should I take? Qalat Aisha to me, alayka bi Ali, stick to Ali. This is after Uthman was killed. So what does that show us? It shows us the position that Aisha, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubayr ibn Awam, all three had against, regarding who? All three of them had regarding Ali was what? That he was the legitimate Khalifa to the Muslimin. And they weren't arguing in that matter. Ba'arakatu Jamal hasn't taken place yet. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Ali's got 10,000 men army. He directed towards Talha ibn Ubaidillah and who? And Zubayr ibn Awam. Ali sent, on his side, Al-Miqdad ibn al-Aswad wal-Qa'qa ibn Amr. Both of them. When he sent both of them to speak to Talha and Zubayr, to speak to them. Miqdad and Qa'qa, they agreed from one angle, and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam agreed from the other side, to not fight one another. 10,000 men of Ali ibn Abi Talib and them not to fight. And they all agreed upon what? That it's what? And now, لا يجوز ترك قتلة عثمان. And it's not permissible to leave off those who are killing Uthman. They all agreed. When Miqdad listened to the points that Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam suggested, he said, is it all you guys want, the people who killed Uthman? Is that all you guys want? You guys are not arguing about what? You guys are not arguing about Khilafah and Ali and you're criticizing Ali whatsoever. They said, yes. There's no problem with Ali. The issue is who killed Uthman? Where are they? How are they just running for free? Naam. So then Talha and Miqdad ibn al-Aswad and Qa'qa ibn Amr, both of them said that then we also agree with you. Wa Aliyun, but Ali, he sees that it's not from the maslaha. Right now it's not a maslaha. تَتَبْعُ قَتَلَةُ عُثْمَانِ الْآنِ. Right now, the following Uthman, the ones who killed him, should not be followed up. Not now. When then? حَتَّى تَسْتَتِبُ الْأُمُورِ, until the matters become organized. And the affairs become good. فَقَتْلُ قَتَلَةِ عُثْمَانِ الْمُتَّفَقُونَ عَلِيهِ. The killing of the ones who killed Uthman is agreed upon. There's no dispute amongst us. But the khilaf is what? وَالْإِخْتِلَافِ إِنَّمَا هُوَ فِي الْوَقْتِ is when. That's it. That's all. After the both armies agreed, نَامَ الْجَيْشَانِ بِخَيْرِ لَيْلَةٍ, they slept the best night they could sleep. وَبَأْتَ السَّبَئِيَّةُ, the سَبَئِيَّةُ, who are the سَبَئِيَّةُ? عَبْدُ اللَّهِ إِبْنُ السَّبَأَ الْيَهُودِيُّ. And he had a group. And inshallah we're going to talk about the سَبَئِيَّةُ in details later inshallah ta'ala. Who are the Sabaiya? They are the ones who killed Uthman. They are the ones who killed what? Uthman. They slept like in what? Bisharri laylatin. The worst night was for them. Ah. Why? لِأَنَّهُ تَمَّ الْإِتِفَاقُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Because the agreement, it came together and they had no place to get in. And that is what the historians, the مؤرخون, the reliable storytellers who have told us stories, who've narrated history to us, that's what they mentioned. Such as Imam al-Tabari, Ibn Kathir, Ibn al-Athir, Ibn Hazm. Ibn Tabari, rahimahullah, he mentions in his tarikh, third volume, page 517. Ibn Kathir mentions it in his Bidayah wa Nihaya. Ibn al-Athir, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions it in his Al-Kamil fi tarikh. Ibn Hazm, rahimahullah, in his book Al-Fisal, fi al-Milal wal-Ahwa'i wal-Nihal. So that's what is mentioned. Then what happened? The Sabaiya are a group from the Rafid and the Shia. أجمعت السبئيون. All the Sabaiyun came together. Abdullah ibn Sabah, his followers, they came together. رأيهم على ألا يتم هذا الاتفاق. That they're going to work hard that this agreement doesn't happen. So what's the solution? They said in the morning, like early morning, what do we have to do? Some of the poets mentioned, no, at night, whilst everybody's sleeping, layl, what we're going to do is, and everyone is sleeping, that we're going to send what? A group to fight both parties at the same time, simultaneously. Both parties. Jaysh, our group are going to fight with who? Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam, fight and throw arrows at them. And the next one is going to, a group is going to go to who? Ali ibn Abi Talib and his army, and also throw arrows and things at them. What happened? Everyone is sleeping. They get shot. Things happen. They see it act as what? That the other party deceived and lied to them. Ali ibn Abi Talib and his party saw that Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zuhair ibn Awam were khainin, deceitful individuals. They lied to us. That's what happened. And Ali ibn Abi Talib's army, Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zuhair ibn Awam saw army and Ali's army what? As Ahlu Ghadr, people of deceit. That's what they wanted. And the reality isn't the case. That's how they made the fitna stand. And the kibar, the people who were wise from the Sahabas, they tried to stop the battle. But no one was able to succeed in that issue. Talha ibn Ubaidillah kept saying, أَيَّا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ أَتَنْصِتُونَ فَأَصْبَحُوا لَا يُنْصِتُونَ فَقَالَ أُفٍ أُفٍ فِرَاشُ نَارٍ وَذُبَابُ طَمَعٍ. Talha ibn Ubaidillah kept saying to the people, oh people, are you guys going to what? Are you guys going to stop this? Are you guys going to just hold back from what you guys are doing? And then he said, oof, oof. Ali on the other side, he's doing what? He's stopping his army. He's saying, don't fight. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she sent Ka'ab ibn Musawwara. Ka'ab ibn Sawra, she sent him with a mushaf so he could start to stop the battle. The Sabaiyun, they grabbed him when he took the mushaf. Ka'ab ibn Sawra, they grabbed him and they killed him straight away. And they threw him on the ground so he couldn't go. The matter became very serious. And Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he mentions in his sahih, the three lines of poetry regarding when a fitna takes place, there isn't anyone who can stop it once the spark of fitna starts. And this poetry is taken from the pre-Islamic Jahiliyyah Imrul Qais. Imrul Qais, between him and the Prophet ﷺ is approximately 150 years of duration. And he's from the first of the Mu'allaqat. He's from the first one of them. Na'am. Imrul Qais, he said, Al-harbu awwalu ma takunu fatiyatan تسعى بزينتها لكل جهول حتى إذا اشتعلت وشب ضرامها ولت عجوزا غير ذات حليل شطماء ينكر لونها وتغيرت مكروهة للشم وتقبيل. He said the battle, when it first takes place, it's like a young beautiful girl. And she's swerving and she's walking through what? With her beauty amongst those who are ignorant, who don't know the reality of her, who see her in a very beautiful form. Fitna, when it first takes place, battles when it happens first, what happens? Huh? What happens is that, it's like that young girl, everybody's running to her. The people are running to the fitna. But look, حتى إذا اشتعلت وشب ضرامها. But then when this girl, she comes directly to you, huh? like the fitna when it takes place and it what? It happens, everyone feels the pain. What happens? وَلَّتْ عَجُوزًا غَيْرَ ذَا تَحَلِيلٍ. She becomes an old lady, you really see her for what she is. She becomes an old lady who's walked away from you. The fitna now, you realize it when it's turned back, it's back at you. You now realize, subhanallah, what has just happened? All those times we were fighting was a fitna. شَطْمَاءَ يُنْكِرُ لَوْنُهَا وَتَغَيَّرَتْ. She becomes an ugly woman, her color changes. And what happens? مَكْرُوهَةً لِلشَّمِّ وَالتَّقْبِيرِ. She's not befitting, she's an individual you would not want to touch. You wouldn't want to kiss her. The smell that comes from it is so bad. And that's what happens to the fitna. Later people understand. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, وَالْفِتْنُ إِذَا وَقَعَتْ عَجَزَ الْعُقَلَاءُ فِيهَا عَنْ دَفْعِ السُّفَهَا. When the fitna hits, the people who are intellectual individuals, they become unable to push away the dimwitted, the ignorant ones who wants the fitna to go. They can't stop them. They can't. فَصَارَ الْأَكَابِرُ عَاجِزِينَ عَنْ إِطْفَاءِ الْفِتْنَةِ. So the elders, the smart ones, the intellectual individuals, they become what? Weak from extinguishing the fire of fitna. وَكَفِّ أَهْلِهَا وَهَذَا شَأْنُ الْفِتْنَةِ. And that is the affairs of the fitna. كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى, as Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً, a trial and a tribulation. لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. It will not only afflict those who are the wrongdoers amongst you alone. That's not. The trial and tribulation goes to everybody else. وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ, that Allah is severe in His punishment. So, Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned that in his Minhaj Sunan Nabawiyyah. So, the Ma'arakatul Jamal, it took place. Ma'arakatul Jamal, it took place. في السنة 36 من الهجرة. When did it happen? It happened the 36th Hijriyah. And this was when? في بداية خلافة علي. This was right at the beginning of Ali's Khilafah. And it started after what? بدأت بعد الظهر. It started after الظهر prayer. وانتهت قبيل مغيب الشمس. And it was carried on until just before the sunset. For that same day. Ali had with him what? 10,000 armed men. And the people of the mountain, Aisha and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and them, their army was from what? 5,000 to 6,000. The narration that Ali ibn Abi Talib, Muhammad ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib was with him. And the people of Jamal, they had Abdullah ibn Zubayr. And a lot of the Muslims were killed that day. It is a fitna, brothers and sisters. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has saved our souls from it. So we ask Allah what? وَنَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ الرِّضْوَانَ وَالْمَغْفِرَةِ. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mercy. And we ask Allah to be pleased with us. And to forgive us for anything we have ever said or done. Also, Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam were killed. Talha was killed and Zubayr was killed. Muhammad ibn Talha was also killed. As for Zubayr, he did not even participate in the fight. Zubayr ibn Awam. And also Talha ibn Ubaidillah did not participate in the battle. And the story of Zubayr ibn Awam is mentioned by Ibn Abi Shayb and his Musannaf, that also Ibn Hajar mentions in his Matalib al-Aliyah. In the chain of narration, of course, there's a rajul al-majhul, a man who's unknown. But the point is that Zubayr did not participate, wala Talha ibn Ubaidillah. It was said to Zubayr ibn Awam, when the fight started, لما جاء إلى المعركة لقي علي بن أبي طالب, they said he met Ali. When the fight started, Zubayr met Ali. And Ali ibn Abi Talib said to Zubayr ibn Awam, أَتَذْكُرُ, do you remember that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تُقَاتِلُ عَلِيًّا, you're going to fight Ali. وَأَنْتَ ظَالِمٌ, and you are the transgressor, the wrongdoer. Zubayr ibn Awam, as soon as he heard that, he went back. And he didn't participate. Did that really take place between him and Ali ibn Abi Talib? Allahu A'lam. Because there is no chain of narration that's authentic, that's strong, that points it. And I just said to you the chain of narration that was mentioned by Ibn Abi Shayba, فِيهِ رَجُلٌ مَجْهُولٌ. There's a weak narrator in there. Zubayr, so he didn't participate in that battle. When was he killed? Zubayr was killed by deceit. He was deceived. Zubayr ibn Awam. The man who killed him, it was the person who killed Zubayr ibn Awam was Ibn Jarmuz. Ibn Jarmuz killed him. He deceived him and he killed him. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, he was killed bi sahmi gharb. What does that mean? He was killed by an arrow that wasn't intended for him. Arrow that wasn't intended. Naam, is what hit him. When the battle finished and the fight when it was over, Ali ibn Abi Talib gained victory from the battle. But in reality, if we analyze that word, no one got victory. No one gained victory, but rather Islam and the Muslims found loss in that battle. After the battle and the fight was over, Ali ibn Abi Talib was going through and he was walking through the dead corpse of the people. And he found Talha ibn Ubaidillah. He found him. And Ali ibn Abi Talib sat him down. And he wiped the dirt off his face. And then he said, Azizun alayya an araka mujaddalan tahta nujumi as-sama'i ya Aba Muhammadin. He said, it is very hurtful towards me for me to see you killed like this. His head was between two rocks, Talha ibn Ubaidillah. For me to see you under the sky of this, the stars of the sky. Ya Aba Muhammad, O Aba Muhammad. And Ali cried, and then he said, وَدِدْتُ أَنِّي مِتْتُ قَبْلَ هَذَا بِعْشِينَ سَنَةً. I wish I died 20 years before this. Ali said, I wish I died 20 years before this took place. And he also saw Muhammad ibn Talha. And he cried. Muhammad ibn Talha, Muhammad ibn Talha used to be called As-Sajjadi. And the reason why he was called As-Sajjadi was because min kathrati ibadati, he excessively used to pray. He was that ibadah. He used to always be found in salah and ibadah. Ali ibn Abi Talib wasn't the only one who regretted it. Rather, every sahabi who participated in it, all of them, bighayri istithna, without any exception, they all regretted it. For example, Ibn Jurmuz, who killed Zubayr, he walked on to who? He came on to Ali ibn Abi Talib. And he had وَمَعَهُ سَيْفُ زُبَيْرِ, and he had the sword of Zubayr ibn Awam with him. يَقُولُ, he said, قَتَلْتُ زُبَيْرِ, I killed Zubayr, Ali. Ali, I killed Zubayr. قَتَلْتُ زُبَيْرِ. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said to him, إِنَّ هَذَا السَّيْفُ طَالَمَا فَرَّجَ الْكَرْبَ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. That sword you have, how many times has it eased sadness from the Prophet ﷺ? It fought for the sake of this religion that you've just taken like that. And then he said to him, بَشِّرْ God tidings to you, قَاتِلْ the killer of Ibn Safiyyah bin Nar, the son of Safiyya. His mother, Zubayr, was his mother was Safiyya, who was the Prophet's auntie. Safiyya bint Abi Talib, bint Abdul Muttalib. Glad tidings for you, hellfire. And he said, don't enter onto my house. Leave me. Don't let him in. When the battle was over, Ali ibn Abi Talib, he went to Ummuna Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. He went and went to her. And he prepared for her a what? He prepared for her a good riding beast to take her back to. To take her back to Medina to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he did this based on the command of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet commanded him to do this. And this hadith is collected by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ibn Hajar. He considered it to be Hassan. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, سَيَكُونُ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ عَائِشَةَ أَمْرٌ. There's going to take place between you and Aisha a matter. Something is going to happen between you and Aisha. Ali then was with the Prophet and he said to the Prophet, فَأَنَا أَشْقَاهُمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, I am the one who is destroyed that day. If you know, Aisha are arguing, then I'm the destroyed one. Then the Prophet said, لا, no. وَلَكِنْ but. إِذَا كَانَ كَذَلِكَ. The Prophet said to him, no. But if that does take place, فَرْدُدْهَا إِلَى مَأْمَنِهَا. Take her back to her place. Take her back to her place, her house. Send her back. And Ali ibn Abi Talib did as the Prophet requested from him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Ahmad narrated this in his Musnad. The question that arises now is, لِمَاذَا لَمْ يَقْتُلْ عَلِيٌّ قَتَلَتْ عُثْمَانِ. Why didn't Ali kill those who assassinated Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu? Why didn't Ali ibn Abi Talib just get it over and done with and kill the people who killed Uthman? The reason is because Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he saw a maslaha and a mafsada in the matter. And that's what he was looking into. Ali was looking into the maslaha and the mafsada, and he was weighing which one is more. And he saw that the maslaha is in ta'khirul qisasi la tarku. That we don't let these people go, but we delay the qisas, the capital punishment. We delay it for now, until matters become controlled. The situation calms down. So he delayed it for that reason. And the ijtihad that Ali based his action on was exactly what the Prophet did. In the matter of what? Hadithat al-ifk. The issue, the forged accusation that was placed against our mother Aisha. Some people spoke about Aisha. From those who spoke about Aisha is the noble companion Hassan ibn Thabit, wa Hamlatu bint Jahshin, and Harmalat ibn Jahshin, wa Mistah ibn Uthatha. And other than them were the ones who participated in what? In the affairs of Aisha. But the one, وَالَّذِي تَوَلَّى كِبْرَهُ, but the one who took over the biggest matter, the one who started off the story, who is the head of this situation, was who? Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. The messenger climbed the pulpit. And look what he said. He said, مَنْ يَعْذُرُنِي فِي رَجُلٍ وَصَلَ أَذَاهُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِي. The messenger said, who is the person who will excuse me, an individual, a man whose harm has reached my family. He's harmed my family. Who is the individual who is going to deal with him? Meaning Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh, he stood up and then he said, أَنَا أَعْذُرُكَ مِنْهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I am the one who will suffice you from him. إِنْ كَانَ مِنَّا مَعْشَرَ الْأَوْسِ. If he's from us, the people of Aws, قَتَلْنَهُ, we will kill him. وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ إِخْوَانِنَا الْخَزْرَجِ. And if he's from our brothers Khazraj, أمرتنا بقتله, order us, he's killing, we will kill him. Sa'ad ibn Ubadah stood up, and he replied back to who? Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh, and he replied, Mu'adhin, sorry. And he said to him, you can't dare to do that. When Sa'ad ibn Ubadah said that, Usayd ibn Hudayr, who was on the side of Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh, replied back to Sa'ad ibn Ubad, and he said to him, you are a munafiq, tujadil ani al-munafiqin. You're a hypocrite and you argue for the hypocrites. You're a spokesman for the hypocrites. The messenger, what did he do, alayhi salatu wasalam? Sara al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam, yukhafidhum. The Prophet started to cool down the situation. So from this situation, the Prophet realized, alayhi salatu wasalam, that this matter is a very, very, very deep situation. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we're all aware of, before he came to Medina, our Messenger, Aws and Khazraj, they all agreed as a tribe, and they were fighting for so long, they all agreed on what? They all agreed to place Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul as their king. They were actually placing the crown on him. They already agreed. So for them, he has a high status. And who is Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul? He took one third of the army of Battle of Uhud back. He said, لو كنا نعلم قتالا لاتبعناكم. If we knew there was a fight, we would have participated. The Prophet here, alayhi salatu wasalam, what did he do? He left off the whipping of Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. The Prophet left it. Why did he leave it? للمصلحة. There was benefit in it. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam saw that if he whipped Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, the man who was being given king, this guy is the head of the tribe, the Prophet saw in it, أَنَّ جِلْدَهُ أَعْظَمُ مَفْسَدَةً مِنْ تَرْكِي. Leaving him and hitting him right now, leaving him is better and there's more benefit in it. And the same was with Ali. Ali saw the delaying of the qisas, the capital punishment, was less in delaying than hastening, min ta'jilihi, to hasten the capital punishment for them. Because Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, knew he wasn't able to kill what? He wasn't able to kill those who killed Uthman. Why? Because they were what? لأنهم غير معروفين بأعيانهم. Nobody knew who they were individually. Nobody did. But they were what? They were heads that were known, icons, individuals who were known. But the individuals who took the hand of Uthman and killed him weren't really known. And they also have what? لهم قبائل تدافع عنهم. They have tribes that are backing them up. نعم.